Nothing quite says Nurgle like a rancid swamp base, and in this video we're going to show you how to do exactly that on your miniatures. Now this technique works best on a base with a model already attached, but for the purposes of this video we've got a spare base here which we're going to show you how it works, just to make it super clear for you guys at home. You'll also notice we've got a skull attached to our base here. This came from the Citadel Skulls pack, which I painted up and attached onto the base. Now once that's done, the first thing we're going to be doing is applying a texture paint of a Grenham Badland onto the base, and for this we're using our texture tool. First things first, grab some paint from the pot like so, and load up your texture tool like this on the thicker end of the tool. Now we're going to get quite a bit on the base, there we go, perfect. Then onto the base, what we're doing here is we're applying this onto the base like so, but we're not going to be applying it all over the entire base. What we're doing is we're going to be spreading it out here, leaving patches on the base. So where that skull is, for example, I'm going to leave a patch there. Then I'm going to leave a patch on this side as well over here. So it's going to leave that base bare on that patch just there. I'm going to spread this out all over the base like so, leaving some patches near the sides of the base to create the sort of swampy bits we're going to be painting in later on. Now, of course, when you're painting this onto the base with your miniature attached, you want to make sure that you're not hitting the actual feet of the model. So when you're doing that, just use the thin end of the texture tool to make sure you're not hitting the feet of your miniature. Once you've applied this onto the base, allow about an hour for it to fully dry. Once it has, it's time for the next stage. There we go, that's the Grenham Badlands dried, giving this really cool crackle effect. Okay, over the top of that, let's add a shade now of Agrat Earthshade. We're going to wash that all over the Grenham Badland, and for this we're using our medium shade brush. Grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. We'll add a little bit of water just to thin it down, but not too much. There we go, then load our brush up and onto the base. Here we're applying a nice liberal wash of this all over the top of the base like so, covering all of the Grenham Badland we previously painted. We're going to let that fully dry and then move on to the next stage. There we go, that's the wash dried. Okay, up next we're going to be applying a dry brush over the top of that of Underhive Ash. Just grab your small dry brush for this. Let's grab some paint from the pot, and here on a piece of tissue paper we're going to just take off most of the paint onto the tissue paper like so. Now Underhive Ash is a dry paint, so designed for this sort of thing. There we go, absolutely perfect. Then onto the base. Here, we're applying a light dry brush over the top of the areas we've just painted here. We're using Underhive Ash here to give us a sort of greeny tone, which we really want for this swampy base. Now, when you're painting this base and your model's attached, obviously when you get near the feet of the miniature, just take your time and make sure you don't hit the feet. You might even want to use an old medium base brush here for a bit of added control. There we go, that's the dry brush done. Okay, now it's time to start working on those horrible green slimy areas. And the first thing we're going to be doing here is applying a base coat of Nocturne Green onto those patches of the base we've left bare. Grab your medium layer brush for this. Just grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Now we're going to add a little bit of water, just a touch, not too much, to thin it down. Perfect, then onto our base. Here we're applying a nice even base coat onto these patches that we've left bare. Just working our way up towards the brown areas like so. Now if you can, try and make it uneven where the patches of green meets the patches of brown like so. This makes it look a bit more natural. So there we go, that's the green areas base coated. Okay, up next let's add some filthy green slime to our base using Nurgle's Rot technical paint. We're going to use it here in a couple of ways. First of all, we'll thin it down with a touch of water to add a thin layer of slime on those green areas. Then we'll use it straight out of the pot to really thicken up that swamp area. First of all, that thin layer. Here, grab your medium layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette here. Now we're going to add a little bit of water here to thin it down to make sure it goes on real thin and slimy. There we go, perfect. Then onto our base. Here, we're applying this on the base like so, all over those green areas. Now you can see it's going on quite thin. That's not a problem at all. It's going to dry nice and translucent. You'll be able to see those green bits underneath showing through. If you accidentally hit the brown areas of the base, that's not a problem. It'll just look like slime is overflowing. Next up, we've got Nurgle's Rot straight out of the pot. And here, we're applying it as a thick layer towards the back of these green areas. We're not going to go as far as the bank. We're going to leave a small, thin green line just between the bank, like so, and this thick bit we're painting on now. Now, you can build this up in as many layers as you like to be as thick as you want. I'm going to add a couple of layers here to make it really thick and goopy. There we go, the Nurgle's Rot has dried, giving this really cool swampy appearance. Okay, let's add some more texture to our base now using some tufts. Now we've gone for the Middenland tufts here, and when they come in this backing like so. To remove them, grab your Citadel fine detail cutters. Let's take one of the tufts from the base like so, with our cutters, just pull it off, then onto the base. We're going to apply it onto the brown areas of the base like so. They're self-adhesive, so you can just press it on like so, stick it on. You can apply as many as you like on your base like that, but make sure you're sticking to the brown areas to make it look more natural. Once we've done that, we'll paint the rim of the base with Rhinox hide. So with the tufts applied and the rim of the base painted Rhinox hide, our swampy base is complete. And just so you can see what it looks like with the finished miniature, here we go. Here is our Death Guard Marine on a swampy base too. And that's how you can paint swampy bases for your Nurgle miniatures. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.